All right, Coach Corbin, thanks for joining us. Looks like you're right there at Vanderbilt right now.
I am. I'm isolated, though. I'm in an office by myself and been this way for the past 4 weeks. So in some ways, it's calming. In other ways, it's a little bit strange because usually around people this time of year.
How is the city of Nashville handling all of this?
I think they're doing a good job. I just, you know, as I've told my folks who are in back in Wolfeboro, New Hampshire, with my brother and sister too, it's probably not a whole lot different than Wolfeboro. There's not a lot of activity. It's a ghost town. And although Nashville is bigger than Wolfeboro, at the same time, you don't see people out. Everything is closed. But at the same time, on nice days, you see a lot of people walking with their children and just doing things that I don't think have been done for a long period of time. So we're handling it okay.
And you've been doing some interesting things on social media. Can you tell us about that?
Well, we've just been recognizing some people in the hospital systems, both doctors and ancillary positions that we felt needed to be recognized. What we did is we just made a baseball card every day of a doctor or someone who's serving over there in some position and kind of bring some light to what they're doing. Mother, dad, what have you, the position they're in, and hospital systems all around the Nashville area, and we're trying to reward them in a way, and it's been fun.
I love it. In terms of baseball, if you had to take a season off, at least you're the defending national champions taking that season off, so that lasts for 2 years now.
Yes, that would be true. No one will ever know what was going to happen with the 20 season, but the last time the College World Series was played, we were the champions. So that was 19, and I guess that will carry over into the next season, the 21 season. So, yeah, that there's a lot to reflect upon that season. We were transitioning to this one, and we felt like we had a pretty good team, but I'm sure a lot of people did. But it would have been interesting to see what would have happened with this group.
Over recent years, you actually recruited a couple of different kids out of Portsmouth. Is this a nice way for you to keep your ties back in New Hampshire?
It is. I think New Hampshire has always been a pretty good baseball state. It's smaller, but at the same time, the players in New Hampshire are just as good as the players in California. There's just more of them in California. And I think the young man that we've got coming from Portsmouth this year, a kid named Calvin Hewitt, we've recruited for quite some time. We saw him in our camp, and we're very excited to have him. He's going to be an outstanding player. He's an outstanding kid, a tremendous basketball player for Portsmouth High School, too. And they lost their opportunity to play for a state championship in both basketball and baseball. But at the same time, I think he's going to really develop here. And I'm proud that he's coming. And I'm proud that we're getting a New Hampshire kid. And we'll certainly continue to recruit that state because they train in elements that a lot of kids down here don't train in.
You mentioned the great baseball history in New Hampshire. Who would you say is the greatest player in our history? We have Carlton Fisk and Chris Carpenter and Mike Flanagan, some big names.
Yeah, you named several of them. Mike LaValliere, Steve Balboni, you know, going back a few years. Carlton Fisk was so memorable in so many different ways. It was unique that he got to play for the Red Sox and then finish with the White Sox. But I don't know, that's a tough question because they're all very good.
Your parents are still here. I think you mentioned a brother and a sister in Wolfeboro. Any messages to the gang back here in the Granite State?
Well, I can't wait to see him again. I mean, we talk a lot on the phone, but at the same time, my sister Erin and my brother Greg are taking care of my parents, Jack and Ann. My dad's 89. My mom is 85. Yeah, they're back home in Wolfeboro, New Hampshire with my sister and brother. And I like the fact that someone can look after them. And during the season, my mom and dad are usually here in Nashville, Tennessee. They bought a condominium down here, and I'm still proud of that, the fact that they can come down and watch us play. And I know that's a big thrill for them. And hopefully we'll get started again in the fall where they can get back down here and watch some fall ball before we start again in the spring of 21.
That sounds like a great plan. Coach, thanks for joining us and stay strong down there.
Likewise, Jamie. Thank you very much for the opportunity.